Hello everyone, and this is ValentinaCharms and welcome to the 8th day of 40 days of Valentine Day crafts. And today I'm going to show you how to make an ECG cookie, and it's really easy. And I got this inspiration off the internet from like real cookies, and it's really easy. All you're going to need for this is a square cookie cutter. If you don't have one, just use a knife to cut a square shape yourself. And you're going to need tan clay and white clay. You're going to need I made this color by mixing Sculpey tan and a bit of yellow, so it's more yellow toned than the actual tan color, and then just not regular white, and make this square smaller than this one. And then you're going to need an eye pin if you want to make it into a charm. You're going to need a toothbrush for texturing, possibly an X-acto knife if you want to cut things and stuff. A needle to for putting the icing on, but this is optional. A brush for the doing the shading, so you're going to need some chalk pastel, and I'm going to use this ogre color, or a kind of yellow tone color, and this brown color. And this is actually green, so like the colors aren't really totally correct, but these are pretty much how they look like on camera. A roller for rolling out the color, but I already did that. And if you want, you can use some other color icing as well for the heart you're going to put it on, and you can make different designs. You're going to like red if you want to, but you have different designs of this cookie, so I'll show you the one that I made. And you're going to need the icing, which is just like deco, Fimo deco gel, TLS mixed with clay so it gets colored, or mixed with acrylic paint, so it's optional. And if watch Sabi Love's tutorial on her Valentine's Day cookies, and you see that she's going to use this little tiny ice ring, and I think it's a brilliant idea, so I just used this. So I'll link her video down below how to prepare this. Any color you like, and I already made some yesterday, so I'm going to show you. And make sure if you're going to cut the icing tip that it's not too big, otherwise it will fail. So I made this design, and it's this is kind of a blue-green icing, a kind of a Tiffany blue-ish like. And I did this by needle tool because I cut the tip too big, and my first attempt was horrible. But okay, on the side note, we're going to make a different design today, so you don't need to have the separate red icing for the heart. So let's just get into the tutorial. So first we're going to start and texture our piece of clay, which I actually already did. Make sure to put the eye pin in before everything else, so just cut it out, put the eye pin in, and so you don't mess up everything afterwards if you want to put the eye pin in. So just go over with your toothbrush over the hole area, and you can also do the back if you want to. I should just do that if it's a charm, because it tends to switch like sides and do every single side, so also the sides, the back and the front, and possibly also the top. If it's going to be like a ring or a cabochon, I should just do doing the sides and front. So when you're done with that, just get your chalk pastel out, and I'm going to use my X-acto knife for scraping off a bit of the chalk. And I also suggest you having like a wipe near you, so if it's coming on your hands or on your workspace, it doesn't get as dirty, because we're going to work with white clay next. So just mix these two colors and just going to dust it all over to get it kind of like a not burned effect, but like if it's baked. Optional is also using this really, really dark brown, but I'm not gonna do that. It depends really on the shade you're using. So depending on what shade of clay you're using, you can shade it accordingly to that. You don't necessarily need to shade the back if you want to. I'm going to do that right now. Just a bit. Just so like, on the site. Okay, so now we're done shading. I'm pretty happy with it. I'm not the best at shading, but it's fine. So I'm just gonna use a wipe to clean my fingers, because it might have come on my fingers and a bit around the workspace, because it's like powder, so it gets everywhere. And make sure you clean your knife as well if you're going to use it later, because obviously chalk will come on other things. Okay, next we're going to put on the white. After you're done with that, just take your tiny icing bag with any choice of color icing and cut the tiniest dip ever in it. Okay, it might be a bit too tiny, but that's okay. So this is going to be really easy. You're going to ice on the sides of the white first. So it should look something like this. And then we're going to make the design in the middle. So I'm just going to zoom in. So then we're going to make the design in the middle. Just take your icing bag and then make the lines. But I'm going to make a different design this time. So put a glass, go up, go down, go down. And then when you're wherever you want to put this, what we're going to do is going to make a line across and then put like a heart design in it, like so. That creates a heart shape, and then just perfect everything else. Like so. And if you mess anything up, I suggest using a needle to make sure it's clean, and then just you can kind of scrape it off and put it to the side so you can see that there was the icing. So I'm just gonna clean it up a bit. Okay, so then you're done, and I hope you enjoyed this tutorial, and yeah, look up for more tutorials. So, bye!